Good day, late fam. So today, me and Tyron, we are planning on spraying the soy bar. So at the moment, we are heading to our nearest hardware store. All the hardware stores are closed on a Sunday, so we may be going to check if Stellenbosch Motorspears has heat resistant spray. So I'm not going to tell you guys the color I'm going to spray the soy bar, so you guys just have to stay tuned for that. So watch the video till the end and you will know what color we are spraying the soy bar, as well as the sway bar brackets, because we're gonna try and get the sway bar to fit on the ASR bar, and we just wanna like to show you guys a full installation on the sway bar. And the low control arms haven't got here yet, or I haven't purchased it yet, because none of the suppliers have my color I'm looking for. So now I'm just gonna respray the sway bar, because they told me the car actually handles better with the sway bar. And I actually saw you do get the ASR sway bar, but I don't know anyone that sells that sway bar here in Cape Town yet, so I still need to find out for that. Maybe I'm gonna ask Version 4, maybe he can organize it for me. But for now, we're heading to Stellenbosch Motorspears, and I'll give you guys heads ups as soon as we buy the product and come out of Stellenbosch Motorspears or when we arrive there. We just came back from Boulder's warehouse, because we didn't go to Stellenbosch Motorspears, we actually went to Midas. Midas didn't have the color I was looking for. And then I went to Boulders, and then Boulders had the color, but it was non-heat resistant. So I don't think it needs to be heat resistant, because it's underneath the car. I don't think it like takes that much heat. So the on the can states from 10 degrees Celsius to 32 degrees Celsius. So hopefully that will be enough to keep it looking good underneath the car. So we're just heading to my home quick to go pick up the sway bar as well as the brackets and stuff, and then after that we're gonna head down to my mom's house, because I'm sleeping there for the weekend. Me and Tyron, we just arrived here at my mom's place, so we have all our cars standing here, Tyron's car, my car, and then my mom's car. We need to clean all three cars because we're going to a show tomorrow. But besides that, let's get back to the programming for today. So I already picked up the sway bar, I picked up all the things I think I'll be needing for today's video, and I just forgot my toolbox, so hopefully that won't affect anything. But me and Tyron, we just need to clean up the sway bar first. We're gonna hang the sway bar when the sway bar is ready to be painted. Then we just have to wait for the revealing process at the end of the video for which color we're gonna spray the sway bar. But for now, we're just going to clean up the sway bar, we're going to clean it up. We are just going to start prepping the sway bar for paint. So we're going to clean it up with nice engine cleaner and sanding paper. We're going to use, I think, what grid we got here. We got 800 grid, we got 320 grid, and we got 1200 grid. So what we're going to use is, we're first going to use the 320 grid, then the 800, and then the 1200, because we want to get all the previous paint off. And we want to get all the dirt off as well. Tyron is going to start cleaning the sway bar with some engine cleaner and some clean water. Then after that, we're going to start prepping it with the 320 first, then the 800, and then the 1200 sanding paper. So there are two brackets on the sway bar which we will have to remove. So is that one right there, and then the other one is situated right there. So we're just going to remove both of them to start prepping the sway bar. Tyron, we got the sway bar fully cleaned up. We just did the 800 grid and the 320 grid as far, so we still need to do the 1200 grid on the sway bar. So what happened is that the sway bar was extremely dirty, full of oil. You can see that's the second bucket of water right there. So I'm just gonna get some fresh water again and clean the sami because I didn't use any other material cloth to clean the sway bar. So I just had the sami here. I'm just going to clean it up with the sami quick. After this, then we're going to start prepping with the 1002. Clean it up again, and then we're going to start the painting process. Darren, have anything to say this far?
I'm good.
Except for them slippers though, but what you got to say?
These nuts! Got him!
At the moment, Tyron is busy prepping the bracket as well. I'm not sure what color I'm going to spray the bracket yet. Not sure if I'm going to spray it the exact same color as the sway bar, or if I'm going to spray it a different color. But the bracket consists of a rubber. This one, the rubber goes over the sway bar. We will be mounting these brackets on the ASR bar. That's if it will fit on the ASR bar. I checked out a few videos for the sway bar on these Hondas, but unfortunately, the only thing they show is that these aftermarket brackets that came on the ASR bar. So I'm gonna see what I can do, but I'm still gonna prep the sway bar so you guys know how to spray a sway bar and how to clean up a sway bar and how to prep it and how to maybe fit it on the car if it actually fits. Then the camber kit for the rear end of the car is that it's only these, I think it's known as drop links. So you only replace these and then you can adjust your camber with these at the rear end of your Honda. So then I will be needing a sway bar, which I would really like though. So if any of you guys know where I can buy an ASR sway bar with the aftermarket brackets and with this rear camber kit, please link me up. Drop a comment in the description below. And what do you think I should do next to the Honda? Because a lot of you actually like the modification of the Biggs bar and the ASR bar. It just has been scraping a lot though. It really has been scraping a lot, so I think I might be lifting the car up. But it will be only after tomorrow's show. I got the sway bar hanged up right now, and I got everything taped up that needs to be taped up that I don't want any spray on. So I got that hanged up to a wire to the back of the roof, and then the two brackets are still hanging there. I think Tyron might attempt to spray those two brackets right there. I'm not sure what color I'm going with the brackets just yet, but I don't think I'm going to go with the same color as the sway bar. So I'm going to start with my first coat on the sway bar right now. So this will be me revealing the color I'm spraying the sway bar. So stay tuned. So yes, I went with the color white on the sway bar because I feel it will suit the car way better because the car is white. I was thinking of doing the sway bar gray, but gray was gray was way too common because all the other bars out there are gray. And it looks amazing though, it's like a nice milky grey, but I just wanted a nice white to suit the car. So, sway bar will be white, but the brackets, we are spraying black. And Tyron is going to be the one to attempt to spray the brackets, so there's no simple way that he can mess this up. This is only the first coat. I don't know if you can see it right clear right there. You can't, it doesn't want to focus at the moment. But it's coming out real nice. I just wanted the first coat just to stick to the sway bar. So whenever spraying, just know you have to leave 5 minutes till 10 minutes drying time between the spraying intervals before you move on to your next coat. Come on Tyron, come on Tyron.
Yes.
Looking good, not too shabby. Nah Tyron, you have it my bro, you have it. The other one too now. What then? Now you can spray your car's roof, me bro. With a blicky. So for today's video, we use the VHD Plus. That's just the normal. I think the caliper spray with the normal black, and then we have the Rust-Oleum. This one is not heat resistant like I previously mentioned, but I'm sure it's going to give you that nice milky effect that I'm actually looking for. So if it isn't milky enough, then I might just put a clear coat over it because I have clear coat there as well.
A few moments later.
So it's been at least like a few hours later and tired and really left. I had to drive to do a drop off quick, but it came out amazing. I mean, like, you can't actually see it on camera, but there's like a few imperfections on the sway bar, but in general it actually looks really nice. I don't know if you can see right there. Oh, if you focus it, it doesn't want to focus on the sway bar though. Doesn't want to focus at all, so you guys will just have to trust me. I will be at the Team Statik Parkhof tomorrow. If any of you guys are interested in coming, I'm not sure if this video will be uploaded tonight or tomorrow, which will be Monday. So just know I'll be at the Parkhof there tomorrow. So please do come support. This bar will most probably be in the car because I'll have to most probably fit it a little later because it's still a little bit wet. It's still wet, and I can't fit the sway bar on like that because it has clamps and stuff like that. If it's not dry by tonight, then unfortunately I will just have to drive to the Parkhof without the sway bar, which is not a problem at all because I've been driving like that for like a few days right now. So this car just needs a clean, but I'm only going to clean the car after the sway bar is fitted or after Tyron actually arrives again, because Tyron, I think, went to go fetch some clothes. I think he's going to sleep over here by me, by my mom. So the sway bar really came out amazing. I just wish like I had like a ESR sticker just to like paste it like in the middle, so that if whoever drives behind me could actually see, look here, but almost looks like a ESR bar. So that would have been amazing. So I'll most probably see you guys a little bit later. If the sway bar is dried or not, if it's not dry, then I'll still be seeing you guys later, and then yeah.
Many minutes later.
So at the moment it's very, very dark, and unfortunately the light here by my mom doesn't work outside, so we'll have to use this light here. So sorry for the bad lighting, but we're gonna fit the sway bar right now. It is, what's the time now, Tyron? 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock.
It's now 10 to.
It's 10 to 7. So like I said, it's very, very dark, and I'm fitting the sway bar only right now because it is not completely dry, but it's dry enough to actually fit it to the car. And I actually want it on the car because I need to go to a show tomorrow. So if you guys don't know what show I'm going to, it's actually just a normal Parkhof. It's of Team Statik, a charity event. So please do support. I'll put the poster on the screen right now so you guys can see the poster. And you guys can decide yourself if you want to meet Mr. Latelet and be in the next Mr. Latelet video. So please do come attend the event, and please do bring whatever you want to bring to provide to the charity, to community. So we will provide a lot of stuff to the charity community, and you will contribute whatever you have. That's what we are doing as Honda Movement CPT. I'm going to be rolling with him tomorrow. So I have to get this car on fleek after fitting the sway bar right now. I'm just going to give the car a nice fresh wash, although it's this late. So I hope you guys will be enjoying this fast forward of how I actually fit the sway bar onto the car. I'm going to see if I can fit the sway bar on the car, because apparently if you check it on YouTube, the aftermarket sway bar actually has like ready-made brackets like that goes on the aftermarket sway bar, but in this case I'm using the factory brackets, so I'm not sure where I'm gonna mount it to the car or to the ASR bar, but I'm gonna try and figure it out. And if I'm gonna struggle too much, I'm just gonna leave the bar and I'm just gonna try and manufacture me some other brackets to get this fitted somewhere in the near future. So let's get started with the installation process. Great, so the light is working outside now, and I just came back from Jody's dad because unfortunately the guy who's supposed to provide me the bolts and nuts, who actually like owns like a house business bolt and nut, which I made use in the previous video, he didn't want to help me. I mean, like, I understand it's Sunday, it's late, but I mean, like, if the box of the nuts is like 2 meters away from you, you could have at least give me 4 nuts. So I'm really disappointed in him for not helping me, because I mean, like, I am kinda in need because the car needs to be ready for a show tomorrow. Well, I don't know how you guys feel about that, but I'm really disappointed in the guy because, well, I'm giving him scope on the platform, and now he just disappoints me and turns me away. So, if that, let's just go forward with this build, because Jody's dad provided me with some great ass bolts that I really hope is gonna work. So, I'm just gonna get some warm water right quick, and I'm just gonna clean the bolts up a little bit because the bolts are a little bit dirty. Just put the bolts on, and let's get started right away with the installation process. Finally got the sway bar sprayed and fitted on the car, so it looks amazing. I spoiled it a little at some places with my fingers, but that's alright because the paint wasn't fully dry yet, but it still looks amazing on the car, and I'm grateful that I'm done with the sway bar at the moment, so now I can just focus on the low control arms as well. At the moment, all I need to do to the car now to prep for tomorrow's show is actually just wash the car, and it's already like past 9. And I still need to go down to Chinaman as well to get a printout for a t-shirt for me for tomorrow. So I'll just be loading the car at the moment and putting all the tools back, and just drive with my mom's car quick to Chinaman, because I need to get that t-shirt and stuff sorted out. So I'm just going to show you guys how the new sway bar looks on the car. So I'm just going to end off the video right here. Thanks for watching this video till this point. If you're a new subscriber, please do subscribe to my channel. Please do click the notification bell to get notified whenever I'm uploading new content. Please guys, I can't do this without you. Please drop a like. Please smash that like button actually. And I hope you guys enjoy the cinematics that's to follow after this right now. So stay tuned for more related content, and I'm going to see you guys tomorrow at Team Statics Charity Parkour.